Hello and welcome everyone, I am Vishal and you are watching the Coding Corner. In this video, we are going to cover the topic HTML lists. Now, for this lecture, we are limiting the theoretical description and theoretical explanation for a limited extent. If you wish to go into further detailed explanation, do let us know in the comments what would you prefer. Alright, let's get started. Now, what are lists? As its name suggests, list in HTML is used to organize your data in list format. And as you can see in the Facebook page here, the list is properly organized so as to improve the user interface. Now lists are mainly of two types, ordered and unordered. Ordered list is mainly used when the sequence of list elements in your list matters very much. For unordered lists, the sequence of the list elements doesn't matter. In this lecture, we are also going to cover the nested lists. Now, nested lists are very much important for improving the user interface when it comes to represent a complex data. For example, you can see the UI of WhatsApp here. There are different list elements. For every list element, there is another list embedded, that is the username and the data transferred. Now, another example of nested list can be index. You might have seen in any book, let's take an example of this course itself. You might see first is HTML, then inside of HTML, 1.1 would be introduction, 1.2 would be, let's say, the lecture of lists, and so on. So this is all about nested lists. Now without wasting time, we just get right into the code. Now I have my Visual Studio code open here and I've just made a note of what we have to cover today. So starting with the unordered list, whenever including unordered list in our HTML, we just have to write UL, which stands for unordered list. And to put our data in the list format, we'll just wrap our content inside of the UL element. So we'll just type li to generate a list element. For now, let's say the Coding Corner. Now, as you can see, the unordered list is ready in the HTML format and you'll see the list as the Coding Corner. So now coming to the ordered lists, to write ordered lists in HTML, you have to write OL, which it stands for ordered list, and declaring the list elements is same for both ordered as well as unordered list. So I'll just type in and I'll just save it. So as you can see in my screen, the heading, the unordered list, as well as the ordered list has been loaded. So for the unordered list, bullet points is by default selected, and for the ordered list, the numbers 1, 2, 3 are automatically selected. Now we can change these. For example, we can just set these dots to circles or even squares. For these ordered list elements, we can choose them and select them as Roman numerals. But you know, these stylings were used in HTML back in HTML4. Since HTML5 has been released, these styling effects have been shifted to CSS, and we'll see these effects in CSS section. Alright, getting back. So we'll now see nested lists. Let's say I want ordered list inside of my unordered list. So I'll type in now I want my ordered list inside of this list element. So inside of this list element, as you can see, I opened the list element and closed the list element, and I'll just embed my ordered list inside here. Now I want the list, let's say record video, record audio, and I'll just hit save. Coming to the browser, I'll just reload my file, and as you can see here, our ordered list is being embedded inside of the unordered list. Now you can just try it as unordered list inside of unordered list, ordered list inside of ordered list, or whatever you may prefer. Alright, so that's it for the day. Thank you for listening to me so patiently, and I hope that you might have understood the topics covered in this video. If you have any doubts, do leave a DM on our Instagram handle or contact us on our new Discord server. The links to our Instagram handle and Discord have been given in the description box below. Now, if you haven't yet subscribed to our channel, please do subscribe, like, comment, and share with your friends so that they can even learn new technologies right away. And if you have any suggestions, you can let us know in the comment section below. We'll surely take it into consideration. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next one. Till then, stay tuned. Happy coding.